Let's take a look at the nastiest two-hole stretch in all of championship golf. Of course, I'm talking about the third and fourth holes at Matamoros Country Club, affectionately known as El Chapo's Taint. The first thing you'll notice from the aerial view is the stark contrast between the two holes, which is a signature of legendary golf course architect Juan Pablo San Antonio. The first leg of the Taint is a breathtaking 386-yard par 4 that can lull you into a false sense of security with its lush green fairway, beautiful flowers, and aromatic scents. The heavy bushes and undergrowth that were once a hallmark of this hole in the 1970s and 80s have long been removed for the much more manicured look that the players enjoy today. The first thing you'll notice as you stand on the tee is how open and inviting the hole is. There's a ridge or protrusion that starts near the tee and runs down the first 100 yards of the fairway that only the most experienced golfers know how to navigate. A great tee shot deep down the middle of this fairway is usually rewarded, as the ball tends to funnel into a wet and sometimes even sloppy collection area that retains moisture due to a lack of sunlight. From there, most players will either flight a little 9-iron or pound a hard wedge onto a green that has actually become larger and more receptive over the years. A par here is a good score worthy of bragging about to your friends. The situation changes dramatically as you step on the fourth tee at Matamoros Country Club, the vaunted second leg of El Chapo's Taint. The first thing you notice is the odor that emanates from the nearby Matamoros Municipal Dump, ushered in with the help of the Santa Ana winds. Shaken, you then focus your sights on the single tightest driving hole on the Mexican Mini Tour. Measuring out at a whopping 411 yards, this hole is a mixture of burnt out dormant grass, dirt, tumbleweed, and worst of all, mud. The key to the tee shot is absolutely committing to a penetrating ball flight. The players here have to somehow manage to get their tee ball past these two bunkers that pinch the fairway in the landing area. San Antonio's genius only gives the players a 7-yard opening here, which manages to repel even the most well-struck efforts. Don't be surprised if you have to hit several provisionals here, especially for those who are navigating the hole for the first time. Once you've finally gotten it in the fairway, the most difficult task is behind you. The approach shot calls for a low-running mid-iron that scoots along the dry, dusty turf onto a putting surface that some say resembles the floor of a well-used dumpster, setting up a climactic end to this two-hole architectural marvel.